our vice secretary. Maybe we can just stand, because not to our own Vizuri, and they may not have been there. So that is Esther, all the way from Sacramento. And we have Mr. Jimmy Mwangi Mbogwa. He's one of the event coordinators. And Mwangi is our event coordinator. And we have Moshiri, our outreach director. We are missing our secretary, Gideon, who was traveling. And we are also missing James Washira. He's not here with us. He's working on the database, and also outreach and membership director. And our youth leader. Oh, I have a cheerleader, right? Yeah, thank you. I think actually this is Mr. Washira's baby. So I think I'm a spear in our babake. I can put the community. So, and we have our youth leader, Daria. She's having her exams next week, finals, so she couldn't be here with us. And my name is Wamboi Jogona, the current chair lady, and I'm honored to be here and to be in your leadership. So I'll read one verse, because most of the people who talked before, they said almost everything that I would have said. So mine, I will read from Psalms 133. It says, how good and pleasant it is when God's people live together in unity. And it goes on to describe how blessed you could be, and ends up, for there the Lord bestows his blessing, even like forevermore. That is what Dr. Jane talked about, and I will not add to that. But I want to talk about Harambee. For those who do not know about Harambee, we have visitors. It's a foundation by Kenyan, for Kenyans, and by Kenyans. We have different things that we do, but we also are looking to broaden our vision. That's not only, you know, the things that we've been doing, helping each other, but we want to diversify, like what Anne was saying. We want to, you know, do a little more. We want to be our sister's keeper, we want to be our brother's keeper. We want to help people who are coming to Kenya to settle down. We want also to grow economically, and that is why we had business people. And I must tell you that this event could not have been possible by our $10. Was what we ate worth $10? Was the entertainment worth $10? It wasn't. And for that reason, we have had all the people who stood for 3 minutes, they sponsored this event partly. Can we give them a clap? And we want a time when we will not have to charge you at the door. We want to be, there to be a time when everybody and anybody will be welcome to our event. But for right now, I mean, money has been spent, and we also have our responsibility to do. But we want to also mentor our young people, you know, help them. We have professionals around us, and from the emails that I've been sending, I've been inviting different people from different professions so that we can come, we know each other, we know what everybody is doing, and so that when you need maybe to be an accountant, you know who you could reach out to. If you want to be a doctor like Dr. Jane, she will tell us her part. And if you want to be in technology like Mr. Kimori, then we will know who to ask. If you want to be an engineer, Monano, we will have all those resources. And maybe if you want to be a fashion designer or a writer, I will tell you who to ask later. So, and we also want to grow as a people. And you know, there are so many resources around us, around Silicon Valley, grants and funds that we have not been able to access. And we've been talking with Anne and many other people, and they have been asking, where have you guys been? I've been talking to people who say, oh, we didn't even know your existence. Mr. Adubu will tell you that. Because there are things that we would do just because of the tyranny of numbers. Just because, you know, we have an organization that people are interested to support us, to fund us. But are we able to go out and reach out to these people? We want to interrelate with other organizations, as I mentioned. You saw the Tanzanian representative, and I've been very thrilled and honored to have some of those people call me and tell me, hey, we want to be in your event, we want to be in your organization, we want to, how can we participate, how can we be a part of that? And we also want to be a part of those people. So the other thing is, we also want to have fun, we want to enjoy. Personally, I like dancing, I like music, I like having fun, I like good food and good company. We have our DJ, and can we give a clap to our DJ, please? Doesn't he do a good job? Yeah? Because, I mean, out of our schedules, out of our different things that we do from January to January of the other year, we probably need a slot here and there where we can just unleash, feel free, dance, and Harambee avails that. I think we are witnesses of that. And we also want to grow in the sense of faith, and that is why we invite community leaders and pastors, because as Dr. Jen said, Harambee is just a drop of water in what we could do. But the bigger part of, you know, the things that we suffer and the things that can help is because we belong to a different other organization. We belong to a people. And for that reason, sooner or later, we will actually have chapters whereby, because I live in Palo Alto and somebody else lives in Pittsburgh, if they are sick, I may not be able to go all the way to see them. But if they know who is around them, then that person can be a representative of Harambee. So we hope to do that. And finally, our vision in networking, as I mentioned before, there is value in networking. And somebody said that you are worth your network. I have experienced that and I've known that, because as a person, you may only do so much. But when you have a big network, you can move mountains. As a person, I may only, you know, go a step, but when we are a network, then we can do 5 more steps. So, the last thing I want to mention is about the challenges that I've faced as a chairperson with my board. I have had to make some very difficult decisions, and the reason that has been is because of our current constitution and our current bylaw. They have a few things that have not been clear. And therefore, I have had to scratch my head and somebody's head to come up with a decision. And I don't think that would be reasonable for any leader. And tomorrow or next week, I'm gonna send that document to all of us so that we can look at it and we see what kind of organization do we want. What is lacking in this document? We are sitting down with my board members to review at least a few things that have been challenging. One of those things is about membership and the benefits. There has been, like, I'll give, you know, just a scenario of where maybe somebody is not paid up and they pay on Friday, the check doesn't get me, and